Can the police really make you take down your COVID relief work social media posts or make you dissolve your groups? And what precautions should you take while holding the government accountable online today? These are some of the questions I'm going to be asking a lawyer and the executive director of the Internet Freedom Foundation, Apar Gupta, today. My first question for you, Apar, is that we've been seeing anecdotes on social media of people being threatened and harassed by the police for doing COVID relief work online. Now, these anecdotes may be substantiated by reports tomorrow. We don't know. Can the police legally do this? Is there any legal basis for them to do this? And if yes, how?
This is clearly illegal. Either it has to be a Section 144 order. It certainly does not exist. It has not been revealed till now. And secondly, there can be a reliance on the National Disaster Management Authority Act. Under this act, under Section 54, there is a power for prosecution for spreading false news, which can result in alarm and cause a kind of public unrest. This is inapplicable because firstly, procedurally, it would need the National Disaster Management Authority, one of the officers under it, to actually go and file a complaint. Or if any other person wants to file a complaint, like even a police officer, it has to give a notice to the National Disaster Management Authority. Only then it can proceed. And further, that tweet, that post, that Instagram reel that you post online needs to be firstly false. It needs to cause panic and alarm, and it has to have that intent requirement. So for all these reasons, we think that people are fairly free even today, and there shouldn't be any legal bar as per the reading of the law.
Okay, so that clears that out. What I understand is that there is a complicated process that even the police has to follow if they want to do something like this. And if they don't follow that process, then it's unconstitutional of them to do that. Moving on, I just want to clarify once and for all. So it's not illegal to do COVID relief work online, nor is it illegal to critique the government online, right?
It's not illegal. You're in fact exercising your fundamental right to freedom of speech and expression. You're also fulfilling your fundamental duties of helping each other as well as promotion of public health.
Glad we got that cleared out. But now what about the reports like the one from Medianama, which tell us that the central government itself issued orders for Twitter to take down at least 50 tweets that were critical of the government in light of COVID? Could you shed some light on that?
This appears from a very problematic provision of law, which is Section 69A of the Information Technology Act, which basically empowers the central government to issue these kind of directions to block specific websites. It's been the power which has been used to ban applications, but also block access to a lot of websites without any transparency. We think that this kind of direction, which has subsequently also been revealed by the Hindustan Times to include about 100 posts which are on Instagram, Facebook and Twitter together, are in fact definitely illegal because they are doing only two things. Firstly, they are asking for help, and secondly, they are in fact also demanding accountability. Now, what can be the consequence of non-compliance of these orders is primarily placed on the social media intermediaries like Twitter and Facebook, which then censor these accounts. In fact, Twitter in a statement has put out that it censors tweets in only two circumstances. One, when it violates its own rules, and second, it's when it gets a legal request, and it checks the legal request when it gets it from a government authority to ensure that whether it's against the Twitter rules. And if it's not against the Twitter rules, it's only withheld within the country where that legal request arises, which is in India. We think this is a very, very worrying and chilling sign of censorship. The government should engage more with people, who should build trust rather than issue such kind of directions which are not even transparent.
Okay, finally, my last question is simply that I'm a little bit freaked out, and I know I'm not the only one experiencing anxiety about this. So what precautions can we take while not only doing COVID relief work, but also while critiquing the government online?
The first thing is that you should verify whatever you come across before reposting it, and you should be reasonably certain that it's not playing to your biases. The second is, when you do voice your dissent And when you do call for accountability from public officials, please make sure that it does not have elements of abuse within it. We know this is a time of anger, of demanding accountability. However, there are a lot of people who are just looking for the basic minimum excuse in order to censor this demand for accountability by itself. Now, you can disregard our advice. This is essentially advice to make sure you stay safe. But do not stop coordinating for help. Do not stop demanding accountability on social media, because India is founded on certain principles of fundamental rights, which include not only the fundamental right to freedom of speech and expression, but today, even in this moment, in this stark moment, the right to life, which depends on our freedom of speech and expression.
Okay, thank you very much to Apar for this much needed expert clarification. It certainly eases my anxieties. Given the kind of resource work that's happening, relief work that's happening, mutual aid that's happening, it's pretty much about our right to life. And so at this point, we must not be silenced. We will not be silenced, and we must all stand together and stand strong in the face of this adversity.